Well, today is our final day of the series of the seven Hebrew root words for praise. Again, in our Bible, it appears as P-R-A-I-S-E. It's seven different deep meanings in the Word of God, Psalms, and in the Old Testament. Number one is Yada, to, I love it, extend the hand to the living God and say, we surrender. Zamar is to strike with the fingers, like if it was a harp or the strings of an instrument, striking with the fingers, making music to sing praise. Number three, Hallel, is where we get a word hallelujah, and it is to be clear in your sound or your color, or do both at the same time, to shine, to rave, to celebrate. Then tequila is to laud or praise highly in song. It could also be called the hymn of praise. Number five, Shabak, means to address in a loud tone, to commend to others the power of the Lord. Six, Toda, which is related to Yada. It's the extension of the hand, this time in a vow, in acceptance and adoration of the Lord. And then today is number seven, Barak. B-A-R-A-K. It means the act of kneeling or bowing, blessing by an act of adoration. This is so important in our society, especially for us that are Americans, that we've been number one so long, we have an attitude, and we need to eat some humble pie, or actually walk with the spirit of humility, like the Lord Jesus, who said, I'm meek and lowly of heart. The Son of God, come on the earth, incarnate, said, I'm meek and lowly of heart. So number seven, for me personally, is speaking the act of kneeling, the act of bowing down, blessing by an act of adoration. It's time to kneel. I mean, is there any service anywhere that you've seen lately, let's go the last 6 months or a year, that actually included kneeling? Now, I know if you're older and, you know, there's medical conditions, I totally get that. But let's go to Psalm 95 and get ready to get your mind blown. Psalm 95, quintessentially, verses 1 through 6. Oh, come, let us sing to the Lord, which is Ra-Nan. Let us sing and shout for joy. Let us make a joyful noise. It's not singing, it's a joyful noise. It's to raise a shout. Raise a shout and a noise with all of your heart to the rock of our salvation. Verse 1, Psalm 95. Verse 2, let us come before his presence with thanksgiving. And the word is Todah. The word we just did before, number six, it means thanksgiving, to be the givers of thanks or the thanksgivers. I love how it put that in the Hebrew. Let us make a joyful noise to him with songs of praise, which is zamir, songs with instrumental music. It means the psalmist are singing over the music being played. Make a joyful noise to him with songs of praise. So that word is zamir. Verse 3, again, Psalm 95, for the Lord is a great God and a great King, thank you, above all other gods. And we go to verse 6, oh, come, let us worship, which is the word shakah, let us do reverent worship with bowing. Man, that's number one. Number two, let us bow down, the word is kara, to bend the knee, to sink down to one's knees, to bow. And then number three, let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, which is our word we're studying today, Barak, to bless, to kneel. In reverent praise and supplication, the Amplified Classic Bible includes. So let's look at verse six, three different Hebrew words. Bowing, kneeling, well, worshiping with reverent bowing, number one, bowing down, bending the knee, sinking down on one's knee, and then three, it actually said, let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. So in one powerful verse, we have, why don't you come and worship, that would be shakah, do reverent worship that includes bowing from the waist. Wow. Number two, why don't you bow down, kara, bend your knee, or just sink down on your knees and get before the Lord. And then number three, it actually says the word kneel, which is the word we're studying, Barak, means to kneel before the Lord our Maker, to bless by kneeling down. The Amplified Bible includes in reverent praise and supplication. So in one verse, the worship is attached to bowing down, bowing at the waist. Number two, let us bow down and let us kneel before the Lord our Maker. Well, the second bow down is to sink down on one knee, actually bend your knee and go to the ground. And then the third one is kneel. So in one verse, we should have more prayer meetings, is my point. Where are you going with it, Kent? Well, it's good for us to get on our face, prostrate, and it's good for us to bow down. We were just in worship Wednesday night at the Gateway House of Prayer. Young singer, very powerful. She's a beautiful worshiper. Right in the middle of worship, on the platform, she just laid right down on the floor. I said, awesome. Let's have more of that. When's the last time a worship team member was so overwhelmed by the presence of God that they ended up saying, you know what? I'm going to leave the platform and go lay at the altar or kneel at the altar. That would be good. Or basically, they knelt down or laid down on the platform so the whole congregation. How many people are there? Well, 100. Well, how many people are there? Well, there are 500. Were there over 1,000? Yeah. And everybody, actually 10% of the crowd did the same thing because of what they saw a worship team member do. And this is why I'm talking about it. Let me say it one more time. In verse 6 of Psalm 95, three different forms of kneeling and bowing down. First, let us worship is shakah, reverent worship, bowing from the waist. Number two, bow down is to bend the knee and sink down on one's knee. And then number three, let us kneel. It literally says our word in English, which is what Barak means. Let us bless by kneeling down in reverent praise and supplication. The expanded Bible says, come, let us worship him, bow down, and bow down, bend the knee. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us. It actually includes the Hebrew definitions. Let us get down on our knees before the Lord who made us. Yes, let us get down. So Barak means a continual conscious acknowledgement of God, an attitude of expectancy, a worshipful attitude, expecting to receive as you're kneeling. It's not a begging attitude, but it's the attitude of yieldedness and surrender. Oh, those two words. The attitude of, I'm yielded to the Lord. Stop right there. What? People say, Kent, how come your worship leading is different? Well, I've really never led worship for people, the people in attendance. I led worship unto Jesus. I was looking at him because he's worthy of it all, and he saved my life. And so I have no problem putting my guitar down. There's many, accurate reports of I was in the middle of the nights of worship. I just put my mic on the floor and laid down. I mean, I was just overwhelmed by the presence of God. And I wasn't doing it to be a spectacle or be a show off. I was going, this is what's happening in my heart right now. Well, you can't do that. You're the worship leader. Well, no, I can do that. I am the worship leader. And I want to revere the Lord from my stomach, prostrate, or bow down or kneel down. That's why I left this for last. I think it's so important from the extension of the hand, number one, all the way through to number seven, the seven Hebrew words, root words for praise. It's so good. And so David blessed the Lord before all the assembly, 1 Chronicles 29, and extended his prayer, ended his prayer by saying, how blessed, now bless the Lord your God, Barak, bend over, let us kneel down and bless the Lord our God. So here we are as we complete the seven Hebrew words, our little series on it. I hope it's been really enlightening, and it should grow, help us grow our praise and our worship life. So Father, we pray right now. We want to be more like Jesus and more like you, more of you and less of me. And Lord, we ask you to define and give us light and revelation on how to be better praisers and better worshipers. Even people like me doing it 40 years, God, we know a thimbleful. So we say, expand our understanding and the heart response to your presence. And we thank you for it now, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. 7 root Hebrew words for praise. Let's get busy. Let's go to work. God bless you guys.